Please remain standing for the presentation of the colors. I call upon Raymond David Gibson to sing the national anthem and the Guam hymn.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleam, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave? The Nogitamoru Purita Nocta Kantai Matunan Yagitoru Ilugar
citation of the infresi, will Senator Frank Bloss Ogun Jr. lead us.
Infresi. Yenin ima sakulugi hina soku, ima sakulugi kora sonu, dan ima sigu nan hina sinahu, hu fresi maisadu, parabayu kurtehi, zahu defendi, ihinengi, ikotura, ilinguahi, iaili, ihanu, dan ikalu tamoru. Niretsaku, diretsu, gininatu, sata, esti, huatitma, gihiru, ibiblia, dan ibenderahu, ibenderahuwa.
For the exit then of the collar guards, please continue to remain standing. And now call upon Father Augustine A. Gumatalta, OFM, Capuchin Guam, to deliver the invocation.
In the name of the Father. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In this moment of sorrow, the Lord is in our midst and comforts us with his word. Blessed are the sorrowful, they shall be consoled. Let us pray. Loving and merciful God, we entrust our brother James to your mercy. You loved him greatly in this life. Now that he is freed from all its cares, give him happiness and peace forever. The old order has passed away. Welcome him now into paradise, where there will be no more sorrow, no more weeping or pain, but only peace and joy with Christ, your Son, and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, Lord. It was now around midday, and darkness came over the whole land until mid-afternoon, with an eclipse of the sun. The curtain in the sanctuary was torn in two. Jesus uttered a loud cry and said, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." After he said this, he expired. The Gospel of the Lord. Let us now say the prayer that our Lord Jesus Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven,
to read Resolution 191-32.
Resolution number 191-32 COR, introduced by Senator Aline Yamashita and all others. It's relative to recognizing and honoring the life and accomplishments of the late Honorable James Holland Underwood II, former senator, for his countless contributions as a stalwart member of the community who was committed to Guam and its people, and to further extending Mina, Trentai, Liheslaturan, Guåhan's humble and sincere condolences to his family on behalf of the people of Guam. Be it resolved by the Committee on Rules of Mina, Trentai, Liheslaturan, Guåhan. Whereas the Honorable James Jim Holland Underwood II from the village of Sinahanya was born on May 4th, 1946, and he is the son of former Senator Raymond Ferdinand Underwood and Mrs. Ana Eclavea Torres Underwood, local entrepreneurs who own Mariana Sales and Tenda Neni in Hagatnya. And in 1988, James Holland Underwood II married Lagrimas Alma Torres Underwood, and he is the father of James Holland Underwood III, the stepfather of Elizabeth Fisher Regis, spouse of Randy Regis, and also the stepfather of Teresa Fisher. And his grandchildren are Jordan, Natasha, Brooke, Summer, and Hunter. The late Honorable James Holland Underwood II was the brother of Rosemary Underwood and a loving uncle to her children, Ray Gibson, Shelley Gibson, and former Senator Mana Silva Tyrone, and he was the godfather of Dave Silva III. And in 1968, after obtaining a Bachelor of Arts degree in business from the University of Guam, James Holland Underwood II would set off to leave his imprint in the annals of Guam history, creating an impressive resume of service to the people of Guam, as well as contributing to the establishment of components for the island's economic foundation. And for a decade from mid-1970s to mid-1980s, James Holland Underwood II served as a senator in the 13th through 17th Guam legislatures. And during his tenure as a policymaker, he served as a vice chairman of the Public Utilities and Economic Development Committees, as well as the legislative secretary and the 17th Guam legislature's minority leader. And as a senator, James Holland Underwood II successfully secured a duty-free shopper's bond financing guarantee to build the AB Wampat International Airport Authority, Guam. He was instrumental in passing the public law that allowed for the construction of sidewalks along San Vitoris Road in Guam's tourism district in Tumon. He played a key role in the enabling legislation of the Port Authority of Guam, and he was one of the sponsors of a measure to regulate fishing methods and protect our natural resources. And he had also served as a delegate to the Constitutional Convention in the late 1970s. And after having served as a senator, James Holland Underwood II would continue his commitment to the development of our local private sector, heading his family-owned business ventures, including Mariana Cells Company and Telepacific Network Incorporated. And he was also JMAA Corporation President, and he would continue contributing to the island of Guam in the public sector, serving as a director and an administrator of various government of Guam organizations under Governor Carl T.C. Gutierrez's administration, and also under Governor Felix P. Camacho's administration. And the late Honorable James Holland Underwood II wore many hats in public service, as he was appointed to serve in many roles, including Director of the Department of Public Works, Executive Director of the Commission on Decolonization, Acting Director of the Department of Mental Health and Substance Abuse, now the Guam Behavioral Health and Wellness Center, General Manager of the Guam Telephone Authority, Acting Director of the Department of Labor, General Manager of the Guam Mass Transit Authority, now the Guam Regional Transit Authority, Director of the Department of Public Health and Social Services, Director of the Department of Integrated Services of Individuals with Disabilities, and Administrator of the Guam Environmental Protection Agency. And he had also served as a Chief of Staff to the Honorable Elizabeth Barrett Anderson, former Senator and Judge. And while James Holland Underwood II was a businessman and a public servant, he was also part of several civic organizations, including the University of Guam Alumni Association, where he served as a treasurer, the Young Men's League of Guam, the Rotary Club of Guam, where he served as a two-term president, and under his leadership, the four-decades-old Kurosawa Student Exchange Program began, and he was also a devoted member of the Catholic Church and was instrumental in having a cross erected on Mount Humazun Manglao in the mountain range of southern Guam, where annually hundreds of the island's faithful make a pilgrimage up the mountain during Good Friday, and for many years during the December 8th feast day of Guam's and the Mariana Islands patron saint, Our Blessed Mother Mary, Santa Maria and Cumlin. The late Honorable James Holland Underwood II had served as a narrator as hundreds of the island's Catholics joined in a procession around the Dulce Nombre de Maria Cathedral Basilica in Guam's capital city of Hagatna. And he also continued a tradition of service during the Christmas Midnight Mass. And on July 24, 2013, at the age of 67, the late Honorable James Holland Underwood II was called home, surrounded by his loving wife, Ama, their son, James III, and his sister, Rosemary Underwood, and family members. And now, therefore, be it resolved that the Committee on Rules of Imina Trentai Dos na Liheslaturan Guåhan does hereby, on behalf of the legislature and the people of Guam, recognize and honor the life and accomplishments of the late Honorable James Holland Underwood II, former senator, for his countless contributions as a stalwart member of the community who was committed to Guam and its people, and thus further extend Imina Trentai Dos na Liheslaturan Guåhan's humble and sincere condolences to his family on behalf of the people of Guam, and be it further resolved that the Speaker and the Chairperson of the Committee on Rules certify and the Legislative Secretary attest the adoption hereof, and that copies of the same be thereafter transmitted to Mrs. Underwood, to Mr. James Holland Underwood III, to Ms. Rosemary Underwood, and to the Honorable Edward J.B. Calvo in Magalhaen, Guam. This was duly and regularly adopted on the 29th day of July 2013, and it's signed by our Honorable Speaker Judith Wampat, our Legislative Secretary Tina Rose Munya Barnes, and myself as Chairman of the Committee on Rules.
We now invite the Vice Speaker, Benjamin Cruz, Senator Respecio, and Senator Anthony Abbott to join me in presenting resolution number 191.
Thank you.
I call upon the Governor Calvo to present the Governor's proclamation. Invite the Governor and the Chief Justice to join me in the presentation of the official wreath of Guam. I would like to call upon Mr. William Raymond Gibson to deliver the eulogy.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, governors, senators, mayor, friends. forgive me if I'm a little nervous. This is my first time publicly speaking. Good morning. I've been asked to deliver a eulogy of sorts here today. Never mind the fact that I may suffer an occasional surge of emotion. This is actually a pretty hard thing to do. A eulogy is a summary of someone's life. And while you can take a 250-pound man and reduce him to a 15-pound box, you cannot take a life as supersized as Jim Underwood's and condense it. You just leave out too many important things. There are some that rattle around in my head. The resolution that was just read to you has a number of high points. That list would be a lot for any man's life. But like I said, I have some things in my head that maybe will give you some pointers, some guidance as to what kind of man Jim Underwood was. He was young when our island was young and delighted in having a hand guiding Guam to where we are today. He loved gadgets. I'm reading his eulogy on one. He spoke fluent Japanese, and when he had a drink or two, sang Japanese fluently as well. I don't remember him speaking Chamorro when I was growing up. That is until I heard him deliver a speech, a campaign speech, all of it in Chamorro, all perfect. I marveled at that skill. Jim Underwood had a lot of titles: senator, director, general manager. He was my mother's baby brother. He was grandma and granddaddy's son and a father. But before he was Jimmy's father, he was our father. We called him Unc. For a long time and for a bunch of reasons, Unc was our father. Shelley and I will claim the best memories of Unc. We had the cuddler. We had the traveling businessman who always came home with the latest and greatest toys. He used to force me to go to Sunday Mass, but always rewarded me with a trip to South Seas to grab some comic books. Five for a dollar. There were other gifts. He drilled into me the discipline to try to think things through. To Shelley, he gave the keys to his vast collection of gas guzzlers. I got to drive the Mariana sales pickup. Many of you will remember the great things he did in the people's service, but he had many other lives that ran parallel to each other, and Jim Underwood lived large in every single one. I cannot summarize Unc's life, but I can share the words of the Desiderata. It helped guide him as it helps guide me, and as I hope it will guide my children. If you don't mind, I'd like to read it to you now. Go placidly amongst the noise and the haste, and remember what peace there may be in silence. As far as possible, without surrender, be on good terms with all persons. Speak your truth quietly and clearly, and listen to others, even the dull and ignorant. They too have their story. Avoid loud and aggressive persons. They are vexatious to the spirit. If you compare yourself with others, you may become vain and bitter, for always there will be greater and lesser persons than yourself. Enjoy your achievements as well as your plans. Keep interested in your own career. However humble, it's a real possession in the changing fortunes of time. Exercise caution in your business affairs, for the world is full of trickery. But let this not blind you to what virtue there is. Many persons strive for high ideals, and everywhere life is full of heroism. Be yourself. Especially do not feign affection. Neither be cynical about love, for in the face of all aridity and disenchantment, it is as perennial as the grass. Take kindly the counsel of the years, gracefully surrendering the things of youth. Nurture strength of spirit to shield you in sudden misfortune. But don't distress yourself with imaginings. Many fears are born of fatigue and loneliness. And beyond a wholesome discipline, be gentle with yourself. You are a child of the universe, no less than the trees and the stars. You have a right to be here. And whether or not it's clear to you, no doubt the universe is unfolding as it should. Therefore, be at peace with God, whatever you conceive him to be, and whatever your labors and aspirations in the noisy confusion of life, keep peace with your soul. With all its sham, drudgery, and broken dreams, it's still a beautiful world. Be careful and strive to be happy. Uncle Jim had lots of love for his family, his church, and his island. But he didn't like cats.
To invite the Governor, Chief Justice, members of the legislature, podium guests, and honored guests to join me in paying our last respect.
As your hearts are filled with joy, lift your hands in sweet surrender to his name. Oh, give him all your tears and sadness, give him all your years of pain, and you'll enter into life in Jesus' name.
call upon Father Gumatauto to please deliver the benediction.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, our Redeemer, you willingly gave yourself up to death so that all people might be safe and pass from death into a new life. Listen to our prayers and look with love on your people who mourn and pray for their brother James. Lord Jesus, holy and compassionate, forgive James his sins. By dying, you open the gates of life for those who believe in you. Do not let our brother James be parted from you, but by your glorious power, give him light, joy, and peace in heaven, where you live forever and ever. Amen. And may the Almighty God bless us all in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Eternal rest granted to James, O Lord, and let the perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Without any objection, so senators, please escort.